الله الرحمن الرحيم. أنا first of all I would like to thank Professor Ines Shaltut for her kind invitation and the whole group of the ASSET group for allowing me to participate in their distinguished Congress. Secondly, I would like to thank the Novo group for inviting me to talk today about the new generation insulin. The story of insulin started 1920 in Toronto by MacLeod and progressed till now. It passed through many, many processes of the time. In your left hand side, you can see the action profile of the insulin we have today. We have a fast acting insulin, but unfortunately the peak is delayed and has a delayed effect. We have a basal insulin, which does not cover the 24 hours and have a peak, so it has a drop, and the premixed insulin. Today, we have an ultra short acting insulin, a basal insulin with extended effect, and the most important thing I think that is going to be there in this generation is the prandial basal insulin. This was for the search of looking for the ideal basal insulin. NPH is a distinguished insulin, basal insulin or intermediate. Its half-life from 10 to 5 hours. Variability, which has been playing an important role nowadays in complications, is very high with NPH. In the beginning of this century, the glargine and the glargine 300, this was the first generation basal insulin analog, half-life 12 to 90 hours. The variability is medium. Till recently, we have the degludec. It's an ultra-long acting basal insulin. Its half-life is 25 hours, but the most favorable story is not only the prolonged effect, and it has less variability, so less complications. What are the objectives of developing of the basal insulin? It should have a longer duration, flat time of action. It has been confirmed in clinical trials, less within day variability and less between day to day variability. And lastly, but not the last, potential for flexible dosing safety in special population as old age and impaired liver and kidney function. So in the search for a basal insulin, efficacy, safety, predictability, and compliance are the main player was there to get this new elegant basal insulin. We see here degludec duration of action. It extends 42 hours, and it's approximately looks like the mean profile. The mean profile in red and the individual is in blue. It covers 42. So it's very important. There is no defect in glycemia in the 24 hours. Degludec has been investigated thoroughly in different clinical and real world. In randomized clinical trials, we have the BEGIN program, switch and conclude, concerning cardiovascular outcome, which is very important, the DEVOTE study, concerning health economic, the BEGIN and switch, and recently, the real-world evidence has been very importantly played there, and they have the reflect, the European treat, and the confirm. You see here the degludec studies in patients with type 2 diabetes in comparison with glargine U300. In the BEGIN study, the overall hypoglycemia, the nocturnal confirmed hypoglycemia, and the severe hypoglycemia was statistically significant. In the switch also, the nocturnal, the severe hypoglycemia was less than the degludec and significant. In the DEVOTE, which has been a cardiovascular study against glargine 100, severe hypoglycemia was statistically significant, 40% less. In the conclude and the confirmed study, the real world data, the nocturnal confirmed and the overall confirmed. That's to say that degludec is safe in most or all the studies concerning the overall confirmed hypoglycemia, nocturnal and severe hypoglycemia. This is a slide which we have to look very thoroughly because it shows us the lower day-to-day variability across different times of degludec in blue, and glargine, either U100 or 300. On your left panel hand side, البانل اللي على الناحيه الشمال هنلاقي ان الدجليدك all the time المكعب الازرق كله سوى واحد، لكن الجلارجين يو 100 بيعلى وبيوطى. وبرضه on the right hand side the دجليدك was less variable than the جلارجين 300. Yes, دجليدك is less variable against other basal insulin. I like this slide because it's some sort of confidence for the doctors. These are the pharmacokinetics of insulin degludec in special population. And your left-hand side in the renal function, either normal, mild, or moderate, or severe renal impairment have effect on blood glucose equal. The age before, more than 65 or below 65 have the same effect. Either those in the hepatic group, the normal, or either child bug of A or B or C, they have the same action. So you can use them safely in those with impaired liver, hepatic, and old age more than 65. In the concluded study, there was consistency of degludec hypoglycemia results across different subgroups. What do you mean by subgroups? The eGFR. Either below 60, from 60 to 90, or more 90. And as we see, there was improvement on the degludec U200 than glargine 300, but unfortunately, it was statistically non-significant. So it was comparable and safe. What about the effect on glycated hemoglobin? The difference between, in the concluded study, between degludec U200 and glargine 300, we see there was an improvement in glycated hemoglobin with different baseline eGFR, either below 60, from 60 to 90, more than 90, and primary analysis. There was an improvement in glycated hemoglobin numerically more than those used glargine. But in the primary analysis, there was a statistically significant improvement with the degludec. This is the chart, which has been from the Egyptian Ministry of Health, which says that the basal insulin degludec can be used for patients with type 1 diabetes with young age, 1 year or older. This slide shows the flexibility of giving the degludec over the week. It's very clear that we have a flexible time to give. Monday, we can give it from 4 to 2 p.m. Wednesday, from 2 p.m. There is a flexibility. On the occasion when administration at the same time of the day is not possible, degludec allow for flexibility in the timing of insulin administration. This new generation basal insulin or ultra-long insulin degludec provides a flat, stable glucose lowering effect equally all over the 24 hours. Ultra long duration of action, more than 42 hours, half-life twice as that glargine, lower within day-to-day variability than glargine 100 and 300, low risk of hypoglycemia in randomized clinical trials and the real world. Always, always for flexibility in the time of insulin administration when needed without comprising the risk of hypoglycemia, not affected by age, renal impairment, or hepatic, and approved from the age of 1 year. This is the breakthrough in the last 2 to 3 years, the co-formulation of the new generation combination. Yes, we know on your left-hand side, this is the action profile which we have today. We have a fast-acting insulin and the basal and premixed. On your right-hand side, you have the ultra-fast. We show the extended basal with less hypoglycemia, but the new era of the prandial basal insulin, which has been very effectively and improving the compliance. This co-formulation between insulin aspart, it's a hexamer, the ultra short one, and insulin degludec, which is a dihexamer. الديجريديك ده هيكسمر الاسبارت هيكسمر واحد وبيحطوا الاثنين سوا وحتى شوف الالم حاطين الالوان الصفراء اللي هي الاسبارت والزرقاء اللي هي الديجريديك في التاريخ حاولوا ان هم الانسولين جلارجين they tried to put a rapid acting insulin with it but they failed because جلارجين is soluble at pH 4 they make a microprecipitate at the neutral 7.4 subcutaneous tissue. لما commercially available rapid acting insulin بيبقى soluble at 7.4 فما بيشتغلش كويس وalso مع لما استعملوه مع الديتامير الشورت acting الريزلتس بتاعت الفارماكوكاينيتكس والديناميكس was unfavorable. في الكوفورميليشن شوف كده انا الصوره دي بحبها بص على الناحيه الشمال كده فيها انسولين ديجليدك اسبارت الديجليدك اللي هو اللونج بيزر 70 الاسبارت 30 ذي اكزيست سيبريتلي زي ما تشوف كده كل واحده لوحدها اللون الاصفر ده الاسبارت السريع الديجليدك اللي هو برولونج اكشن ولما بتحقنهم سبكوتينيوس الانسولين اسبارت بيعمل الرابيد ديسوسيشن بيفك بسرعه الديجليدك سلو ديسوسيشن وهنشوف الصوره الجايه المنظر اللي انا بحبه جدا دي الصوره بتاعته في الالم اللون الاصفر قلنا الاسبارت واللون الازرق اللي هو الديجليدك لما بحقنهم سبكوتينيوس شوف حضرتك بعد ما يطلع كده الاسبارت بيفك بسرعه على طول وبعديها بشويه بقى ياخد له 10 دقائق ربع ساعه نص ساعه يبتدي يفك الديجليدك السلايد دي فيري انفورماتيف بتوري انه الانسولين اسبارت ذي ديسولف فيري رابيدلي اللي هو شورت اكتنج 1 ويورينا انه الديجليدك بي ديسولف او بي سيبريت فيري سلولي ده ديستينكت برانديال اند بيزر جلوكوز لورنج افكت ده جلوكوز انسولين انفيوجن ريت في الناس اللي بتاخد الانسولين ديجليدك اسبارت A steady state in patients with type 1 diabetes بنلاقي اللون الازرق البيزل والاصفر اللي هو البرانديال اللي بيبقى موجود يعني اضطر ان هو يحقن جلوكوز عشان يبان البيك اللي موجود عندنا ده الدراسات اللي اتعملت على الرايزوداك او على البيزل شورت اكتنج 1 was studied in various clinical situation في التايب 1 diabetes insulin degludec aspart once مع aspart against البيزل بولس يعني واحدة انسولين ديجريديك اسبارت ومعها اثنين اسبارت اجينست البيزل بولس في التايب 2 دايابيتس الانسولين ديجريديك اسبارت فيزر فيرسس بيزل انسولين الانسولين ديجريديك اسبارت فيزر بيزل بلس الانسولين ديجريديك توايس ديلي فيرسس بيزل لاست بات نوت ذا لاست ان تايب 2 دايابيتس ستاديز فيرسس بري ميكسد ده فيري امبورتنت انيشيشن اوف versus pre-mixed أو intensification versus pre-mixed insulin. رشيد ده صديق هندي uncontrolled in basal insulin and needs addition of a mealtime insulin. رشيد الجلايكيتي هيموجلوبين بتاعه is not at goal. البوست برانديال بتاعه عالي بياخد basal insulin والماكسيمم ميتفورمين والصايم بتاعه مظبوط معنى كده ان رشيد محتاج للبرانديال او الشورت اكتنج ولو اديله الرايزوداك او الانسولين اسبارت ديجلوداك ده احسن لي لان الكومبلاينس هي حقنه واحده. البريميكسد انسولين از ا جود واي بت الفاريابيليتي في الجلايسيميا doesn't cover 24 hours بيحتاج ان انت تعمل ريسسبنشن. البيزل بولس عندنا البردن اوف مالتيبل انجكشن complex titration, possible low adherence and compliance. The medical alternative option for basal insulin type 2 for glycemic control, most people on basal insulin are not on target glycatomoglobin. عشان كده لازم ازود short acting. Hypoglycemic events are costly and barrier to achieve target. لما بستعمل بيزل من غير هايبوغلايسيميك افكت وشورت اكتنج معاه less incidence of hypoglycemia. One injection or one pen containing a basal and a short acting is less complex system وبيزود الادهرنس للانسولين ثيرابي. Before I finish, Mr. Chairman, this is a very elegant study which has been published in the Research Clinical Practice 2015. It's called step-by-step trial, intensification of basal insulin. Patients with type 2 diabetes, their number around 500, they pass either one of two routes, insulin degludec aspart, our player with oral anti-diabetic agents, or insulin glargine once daily, plus aspart once daily, plus oral. يعني الأول حاطين البيزل إنسولين الجاهز معاه الشورت أكتنج اللي هو الريزوداك against إن أنا أحط بيزل إنسولين معاه الشورت أكتنج الاثنين كل واحد لوحده وفي المجموعتين في أورال أنتي دايابيتيك إيجنس. دي لغاية 26 أسبوع. لغاية ما يكمل بقية ال 38 أسبوع الإنسولين أسبارت once daily or twice daily plus oral antidiabetic agents, الانسولين جلارجين plus insulin aspart once or twice or third. Let's concentrate a little bit on the first 26 weeks. We see in those receiving basal insulin plus oral antidiabetic agents, they are going to have an insulin aspart plus oral to reach the target, basal plus insulin aspart twice daily, basal plus three injections short acting. This is intensification. But our group, we see here, basal insulin plus oral antidiabetics, and immediately you add the insulin degludec aspart in one pen or one injection, and you can give it then later twice per day. And you see in the first 26 weeks, and step-by-step study, that the glycated hemoglobin was elegantly or successful in those receiving the Ryzodec. The confirmed hypoglycemia was less 10%. Nocturnal confirmed hypoglycemia was 45% lower. The total daily insulin was 12% lower. And the number of injections was one contra or against the other group. You have a flexibility. You can either, when you are traveling, you can have your medication at 1 p.m. or if you have a long meeting, you can have it at 8 p.m. The patient can change the time of administration as long as Ryzodec is dosed with the largest meal. The name of the game is to give Ryzodec with the main meal so as the basal can work and fix fasting and the short acting can tackle the prandial or the food in the largest meal. This is the way of titration. If you are within the normal range, those adjustments should be based on the lower three preceding fasting blood glucose, and do not increase the dose if hypoglycemia or symptoms or hypoglycemia is present. If you are above the target, also those adjustments should be based on the lowest of the three preceding fasting blood glucose, and you can add 2 units. Do not increase the dose if hypoglycemia or symptoms of hypoglycemia are present, or you are below the target, those adjustments based on the lowest last preceding 3 days, the mean last lowest 3 days, do not increase the dose if hypoglycemia or symptoms of hypoglycemia are present. Insulin degludec can be used in pediatrics, elderly, renal, hepatic, but concerning pregnancy, there is no clinical experience concerning pregnant women. The Ryzodec is pre-filled insulin with no push button. We don't need a strong force. Can be used 4 weeks after the first injection. End of those click. تسمع صوت لما بتدي الجرعة كاملة. Insulin degludec aspart or Ryzodec once daily, simple, flexible regimen, lower number of injections, lower insulin dose, less glucose monitoring, and lower risk of nocturnal hypoglycemia. Lastly, Mr. Chairman, I do thank you very much. شكرا جزيلا.